part two of the Bat Keyser Bar build. I got my workout doing test fits on this thing who knows how many times. Right now I was seeing if the process of sliding this thing in the back worked, and also checking my height on the trim that I put on the sides to make sure that when I put the top on, everything would actually line up and it would actually work. I'm also checking the thickness on the top to make sure that when I put the towel on, everything's gonna line up and look clean. The pieces of trim that I used for the top were actually perfect for the thickness of the travertine towel that I had, so that they would be down just slightly. And I was lucky because the thickness of the travertine towel, along with this trim and the thin set, made it perfect to towel the top of this thing when I was done. I attached the OSB to the trim out square that I made for the top, and now it's on to set up the rest of the trim. So there's an overhang between the bar top and the box that I actually built to hide the freezer. Started working on a 2-inch trim that hangs down below the lid. This will cover the gap that's created between the actual freezer lid and the top box that I'm creating for the Keyser bar, so that it all looks like one piece. Then back to work on the coffin top. This is the back piece, so it's just thin plywood that I'm just gluing and nailing onto this, since it's all cosmetic. I hit all the edges and all the corners, all the gaps and pinholes with wood filler. After I sand this and paint it, I wanted to make sure that everything trim-wise and decorative-wise looked like one piece. I ended up cutting off edges on the back because after I test fit the lid, I realized when I opened it up, it was going to hit that back corner. This is when I decided to add more to the front. I felt like it was looking a little bit too plain, and I also wanted to mimic the tap handles that I had planned later on, so those two shapes tied this whole thing together. I'm prepping the front board for the coffin top, drilling these holes out so the shank will come through. I lined all the wood that wasn't part of the actual freezer and in the coffin top with this 1-inch insulation foam. It was pretty cheap, really easy to work with because you just cut it and snap it. And I wanted to make sure that I had everything as insulated as possible so that I was getting good pours. Before I made this thing, I researched online and I found out a lot of people had issues with foamy pours due to the temperature difference between where the kegs are sitting and the coffin top. One of the ways to mitigate that issue in a coffin top is to insulate it as much as you can and to keep a fan circulating the air up so that the temperature between the coffin top and where the kegs are sitting is the same. That's why I used this 1-inch foam insulation everywhere I could. Now I'm routing the electrical wire for the light that's going to light up my menu. I got these cool LED lights that not only dim, but you can change the color of. It's pretty cool for the menu because if I got bored, I could change the color of the light that sit on the menu. I put trim pieces on that removable top portion. I also put trim pieces on the permanent back. Did this to tie the two together so it looks like it's all one piece, and also just to make it a little bit more secure and easier to slide that piece in and out so you're not looking at the seams. I did a quick outline of where my drip tray was going to be because this is going to go all the way through the lid and drain down into a bottle. Then I started drilling out the holes and the openings that are going to run the lines up into my coffin top. I did two of these. One so that I could run all the lines up, and I could set a fan up that's going to circle the air up into the coffin top to keep the beer lines and the coffin top the same temperature as the rest of the bar. Drilled my drain line for my drip tray, and I also had to router out the difference to make sure that this was going to be the proper depth so that it would sit on top of my travertine towel, it wouldn't stick up from there. After that, I just started using the router to smooth off all the edges of the rest of the wood pieces for the trim top. I used the same 45 degree angle router bit on all my trim pieces. I wanted that to tie everything together, keep the angular theme going for the bat bar, and it really did make it so that the whole bar, all the trim pieces, and the front tied together. If you decide to build your own Keyser bar, one thing you want to make sure you do is hit that like and subscribe. I really appreciate it, helps out my channel, and it bumps up my videos. This piece that goes across the back screws into the frame of the box that I created, and it also screws into the collar that I put on the Keyser bar. This is the piece that actually is going to secure both of those pieces together to make them rigid so the freezer doesn't slide around when you're opening and closing the lid. Next was drilling out holes to use bolts to and then I also drilled out the hole for the drain for the drip tray. I drilled out and then cut out the holes in the top of the freezer lid. This just matches the holes and the cutouts that I put in my bar top so that my beer lines can go through and I can set up my fan for airflow. Doing one of my mini dry setups just to see how everything looks together and make sure I didn't miss something in a measurement and make sure that I'm happy with it before I actually start securing everything together. That's my menu that I'll be using Velcro to attach to the back to label my beers. And I just made that out of a piece of plywood. If you are thinking about building yourself a Keyser bar, I hope that this video has given you the encouragement to do it. This was a really fun project. It took a lot of time, but I wasn't in a rush. I was the client, so I could take as long as I wanted to get it done. And you can kind of do it however you want. If you want to do a basic one that ties into your furniture, you do that. If you want to do a themed one like I did, you could do that. It's not a real expensive project, and it is a lot of fun. And you'll probably get a lot of compliments when people come over because you've got a custom Keyser bar. You can pay a lot of money to buy a pre-made Keyser, but building one yourself the way you want it, customizing it, not only is it less expensive, but it's definitely more personal. The bar is starting to take form. Be sure to check out part 3 of this Bat Keyser bar build.